what aquaponics is, in essence, is a way of capturing the excess waste from the fish and converting that into plant biomass.
So we're here to show the general public, educate people about aquaponics, but also bring in people who are interested in doing this themselves, whether on a commercial scale or a backyard scale, show them what we've learned through the project and give them a great visual that can help get them started.
Urban ag can take a lot of different forms, and it's worth exploring all those forms. That's part of what this project is about. Hi, I'm Dave Love. I work at the Johns Hopkins Center for a Livable Future. We're on the grounds of the Cylburn Arboretum here in Baltimore City, and behind me is a 1,200 square foot greenhouse that we converted into a fish farm. And our project is in partnership with the city, Department of Recreation and Parks. We really couldn't be doing what we're doing without them. The hoop house that we're in is their hoop house, and they're lending it to us for the project. In traditional aquaculture, the fish you raise, the waste gets sedimented out and is either collected or washed away into the environment as ultimately as a nutrient pollutant. So in aquaponics, we're capturing that waste and turning it into energy or plants.
About half of the seafood that people eat globally is from aquaculture instead of wild-caught populations. Many people think that aquaculture is the answer to declining fisheries, but the way that it is practiced currently, it is also closely linked to further overfishing. About 17% of wild-caught fish are processed into fish meal and fish oil, and the majority of those products are used for feed in aquaculture. The aquaponics project at the Cylburn Arboretum is a great demonstration of another way that aquaculture can be done. So instead of large industrial operations near shore or offshore, where there can be a lot of issues with pollution or food safety due to use of chemicals and other drugs, if we raise fish in a closed system where the pollution is not affecting wild populations, it's not affecting the environment, it's actually being used to grow plants. It's just a great example of another way that aquaculture can be done in a more environmentally responsible and sustainable way.
Aquaponics always struck me as really interesting because it combines two systems, the system of aquaculture and the system of raising plants hydroponically, in a way that kind of eliminates the waste from each system. So the fish waste is utilized by the plants, and the plants filter out the water for the fish and don't require excess fertility. The other purpose of this project is to look at aquaponics from a research perspective, look at its economic vitality and viability, look at some techniques that might work versus others that don't work. Part of what we're doing here is figuring out which plants grow well in this sort of system, both in water and with the nutrients that the fish have to offer.
In aquaponics, both the fish and the plants become a profit center.
I think for us, plant life is definitely going to be the more important crop in the system. I think it has actually more potential to make money because of the slow rate at which the fish grow. You can harvest plants on a regular basis. However many successive plantings you do, you can do continual harvests. And you can also plant very high dollar things, such as basil. Some of the culinary herbs can have a really good value. They'll continue to grow back. They're kind of unstoppable in the summer. We joined a group called the Farm Alliance of Baltimore City. And there, you can kind of think of them as a cooperative of urban farmers. So they work with growers within the city limits, and they basically provide a variety of support for their members. And one way is that they actually have a stand at the Waverly Farmers Market.
The Farm Alliance of Baltimore is a collective of urban farms that joins together to pool their produce and sell it at the farmers market and direct source to restaurants. So it's a way to combine forces for greater good. It's important that we sell our produce that we raise at market value, so we don't undercut the other vendors here that are actual farmers and not a demonstration project.
We plan to use the tilapia in our cafes at Johns Hopkins Homewood campus. Tilapia is a very popular fish, and it's very versatile on how it's produced and how we can give it different flavors and tastes, and it matches well in a lot of different cuisines.
So far, we've gotten a lot of positive feedback from the community. Mainly individuals calling and asking how they can build something like this in their own backyards.
So it's very achievable for somebody who wants to do it in their backyard. Raise some fish, raise some veggies. It could even be done outdoors seasonally because the fish, you know, can mature in as little as 6 months. So you could avoid that whole winter and need for a hoop house and heating.
What I'd really like to do is show people the path to urban agriculture. Doesn't just have to be row crops. Vegetables, they can really get creative. If you have the space and you have a tank, you can start growing fish.
As we see all the people who come through our door on a daily basis, hopefully they'll get inspired. Maybe they'll be inspired to start their own aquaponics system, or maybe they'll just be inspired about sustainable agriculture in general, making those food choices that are better for the environment or